Oh my God, where am I now? I feel so happy. I feel so peaceful. This is heavenly. Oh, was that a dream? For a few seconds, I felt myself in heaven. I felt extremely happy and peaceful. Do you think heaven is just a feeling? Or is it another world? How can we make our life a heaven? Will our deeds lead us to heaven? Dear children, do you think the boy could experience life better through his deeds? Would that be heavenly? Yes, we will find it out. Dear children, welcome back to your English class. Do you remember our last class? Could you tell me where did we leave the brother, the great artist? Yes, exactly. We saw him in the middle of an audience. How was his picture? Yes, it was beautiful. How did he make it possible? Yes, he made it possible by following his sister's words. Now, dear children, have you done the assignment that I've given to you? I'm very sure that all of you have done it. Would you like to listen to one? Here you go.
Today was an unforgettable day in my life. It was with grief I went to the field. I thought about my sister all the while. I painted pictures for her. When the last time I was here, she too was with me, anchoring me to draw perfectly. She pointed out my mistakes and corrected me. She taught me to do my work with dedication and honesty. I miss you, my dear sister. You taught me that perfect love could make you do anything. You are only one who supported me in all my difficulties. You are an inspiring presence. You told me to dedicate my picture to the one whom I love very much. Yes, I did it for you. It gives me a strange power. You are right. It really helped me a lot to endure my pain. You are right. You helped me to complete the picture. I promised for you. Dear sister, your love, your words, your grief. Everything really changed me a lot. May your soul rest in peace.
Children, have you listened to him? Wasn't that a good attempt?
Yes, definitely it was a very good attempt.
Let's find out. How did he begin? Can you tell me?
Yes, he wrote the date and time.
And what about his first sentence?
Exactly. He declared his state of mind by saying that it was an unforgettable day.
And how about the feelings?
Yes, he wrote his personal feelings and thoughts connected with his sister.
Now, what about the tense he used? Haven't you noticed it?
Yes,
you were right. He used simple past tense.
That was a good attempt, dear children.
Wasn't that? Now, do you really enjoy the story? Whom do you like most? Sister or the brother or both of them? Do you like the boy or his sister?
Yes, both of them are very, very good.
Do you think the great artist wants to say something to us? I hope he has something up his sleeve. Let's see. Let's read and find out. Listen carefully.
It seemed as if a soft voice of his long dead sister that spoke only to his heart answered back. Not sorrow, but love, and perfect love has all the good qualities in its gift, and from it comes all the other things, all things except for happiness.
How does one find happiness? Interrupted the boy. Finding happiness is a strange case. The answer seemed to be, if you want to find it for one's own self, then one must seek it for others. But happiness is so difficult to seize or to find.
Perfect love helps one to live without happiness. His own heart answered to himself. And above all things, it helps one to work and to wait. But if it gives one happiness too? He asked eagerly. Oh, then it is called heaven. Have you listened to it attentively? I hope we must read it a second time, silently. Have you finished reading? Okay. No, it's sorrow, but love and perfect love has all the qualities in its gift, and from it comes all the other things, all things except for happiness. Can you tell me who said this?
Not sorrow, but love. And perfect love has all the qualities in its gift. And from it comes all the other things except from happiness.
Yes, it seemed to the boy the soft voice of his long dead sister spoke to him. Now, how can one find happiness? If you want to find it for oneself, then one must seek it for others. Can you tell me what's the meaning of seize? Yes, seizing the opportunity, which means capturing. Now, what does the boy's heart answer him? Could you guess? Yes, the boy's heart answers him that perfect love helps one to live without happiness. Oh, then it is called heaven. Can you tell me what is the meaning of this sentence? Oh, then it is called heaven. Can you guess it? Exactly. If perfect love helps one to work and wait and gives happiness too, then it is called a heaven. So, dear children, the soft voice of his dead sister seems to correct him that it was not grief that work wanders, but perfect love. It makes us feel stronger and face difficulties in life. It will give you everything except for happiness. And she answers him that if you want to find happiness for oneself, we must seek it for others. We must do it for others. We must find it for others. The boy's heart tells him that perfect love helps one to wait and to work. And the girl's soft voice asserts that if it could give happiness too, then it would be a heaven. Wasn't that an amazing story? An inspiring one? Yes, really. The story by Lucy Clifford is highly inspirational. Dear children, you have now completed reading the story, haven't you? Now, shall we recollect the story once again? Could you tell me the title of the story? Yes, it is The Light on the Hills. Who is the author of the story? Exactly, Lucy Clifford. Where does the story take place? Yes, the story takes place in a field overlooking the hills. Now, could you tell me the personality traits of the character of the boy? What kind of a person was he? Yes, the boy is very doubtful, confused, and he is less confident. Now, what about the girl, his little sister? What kind of a person was she? Yes, exactly. She is motivating, supportive, more matured, and loving and caring. Now, tell me, what is the main idea of the story? Yes, perfect love and dedication to one's work could bring forth success in one's life. Now, what did you feel reading the story? How was the feeling? Did you feel touched? Yes, exactly. You feel touched, you feel motivated, and you feel positive. Now tell me, what pictures come into your mind when you think about the story? It's of course the glimmering sunlight, the light on the hills, the boy and the girl standing in the field trying to paint the picture, mother comforting the boy after the death of the girl, And of course, the painting exhibition, the audience, etc. Now, have you noticed one thing? Whose point of view is the story told? Yes, it is told in the point of view of the boy. Now, what are the different types of conflicts in the story? For example, external conflict and internal conflict. Can you find out any external conflict? What is that, an external conflict? A conflict that comes from outside? Yes, the boy's desire to paint a picture, and he is afraid of the response of the society. If it is imperfect, he will be attacked by them. And what could be the internal conflict? Yes, the boy has the same desire to paint the picture, but he lacks self-confidence. He needs motivation, right? Okay, now you can take the short story analysis activity number one and fill in those columns. Now, there is a flowchart to be filled. Let's do that. I'll ask you certain questions. Go on answering me, and the answers you will be writing in your flowchart. Shall we do it? What does the little sister do? Yes, she watched her brother painting the picture. Did she suggest anything? What did she suggest? Yes, she suggested a few changes. Was the boy able to draw the picture? No, the boy was unable to draw the picture. What does she do? She tries to instill confidence in him. What happened suddenly? A big tragedy struck the family. How did he react to her death? He was filled with grief at the death of his sister. Now tell me, what gives him power to draw the picture that wins the prize? Yes, sorrow of a sister gives him power to draw the picture. Now how does perfect love help one? Perfect love helps one to work and wait. What is it called then? Exactly, then it is called heaven. Now you can fill in the chart. Dear children, if you want to express your admiration and compliments to someone who lives far away from you, how will you communicate? If you want to appreciate this little boy who grew up to a great painter, what will you do? Yes, that was a good answer. Writing letters. Will you be writing your personal feelings? Yes, exactly. Do you know what are those letters called? Yes, they are called personal letters or informal letters. Have you heard about a renowned father who wrote letters to his daughter? Could you guess his name? Exactly, he was Jawaharlal Nehru. Could you name the book? His collection of letters to his daughter? Yes, Letters from a Father to His Daughter. Very good. Have you read it? If not, you must read it, okay? Let's glimpse through one such letter. Dear children, haven't you enjoyed the story? Do you like the boy? Have you understood how he became a great painter? Yes. Can you tell me who was behind his success? Yes, it was his sister. Do you think it was easy for him to fulfill his word to his sister? Definitely it was not at all easy. He had a lot of struggles. Now, don't you feel happy at his success? Don't you feel that you should appreciate him, congratulate him? Yes. Then how will you let him know your feelings? Yes, you are right. A letter. We will write a letter. How about writing a letter to him congratulating him on his success? Shall we try? What is the first thing you will write when you write a letter? Yes, we must write the date and the place. Then, how will you address him? Dear boy, or you could give him a name. And after that, what will you do? What will you write next? Yes, you must tell him who you are. Then, what next? Yes, we will let him know that we have learned his story and we are too inspired and we feel proud at his success. And then we could congratulate him. Also, you could tell him that we are always with him. And thus, we could possibly wind up the letter. But what should we write when we end the letter? Exactly, we could write, we should write yours lovingly. And you should write your name. Here is one letter written to the boy. Let's listen to it.
Dear Roshan, I'm Amita from Tirur. You may not know me. I've read your story. I'm quite impressed by it. And was so surprised. And I really appreciate your hard work and dedication. Moreover, you are a brave soul. You have bravely withstood the test of trails. Not everyone can do that. Hats off to you. You taught me a new lesson. Lingering on sad events would not give you anything. Instead, if you can turn that painful event into something positive, you could reap in success. You proved that love could make possible all the impossible in this world. I'm a great fan of yours. Thank you for instilling courage and confidence in me through your story. You are a good example to emulate. I wish you success.
So, dear children, the story Light on the Hills ends here. But the motivation and the positivity that it spreads, it never ends. Perfect love, honesty, and dedication could make one's world a heaven. Our actions and how we do it determine our life to become a hell or a heaven. The boy grew up to a great painter, supported by his loving, encouraging sister. She directed him to positivity. She corrected his actions, and the boy too followed it religiously. And the result you have seen, he has become a great artist and a good, happy human being. Mahakavi Ullur Paranyadupole, Namikkil Uyaram, Nadugil Thinnam, Nalgugil Nediyidam. നമുക്ക് നാമേ പണിയുവത് നാഗം നരകവും അതുപോലെ ജീവിതം മനോഹരമായ ഒരു കാവ്യശകലം പോലെ ആയി മാറാൻ മൂല്യങ്ങൾ ഹൃദയത്തോട് ചേർത്ത് പിടിക്കുന്ന നിസ്വാർത്ഥമായ കർമ്മങ്ങൾ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ചെയ്യുവാൻ കഴിയട്ടെ അറ്റ് ദ എൻഡ് ഓഫ് ദി ഡേ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ ആർ ആക്ഷൻസ് ടു മാറ്റർ ഹാവ് എ ഗുഡ് ടൈം എഹെഡ് ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ സ്റ്റേ സേഫ്